facetious, bro.
You're wearing it.
Okay.
What message do you send your team to take something from that fourth quarter the other night and use that moving forward?
Well, you combine that with just that we have to play for 48 minutes. You know, we're on a three-game losing streak at SAC, at the Clippers, and home against Houston. And the common theme there for three quarters, we've played good basketball, winning basketball, and there's been one quarter in each of those three. Whether it's the second quarter in SAC, minus 19, second quarter in LA, minus 19, then obviously the third quarter the other night, minus 14. When I showed the clips of that fourth quarter yesterday, I just kept on remarking, we didn't make any change in terms of coverage. We made a big change in terms of energy, effort, care, want to, and urgency. And we made them feel us, we pushed them out, and we became the more aggressive team. And if we're going to get out of this three-game losing streak, because they're on a three-game losing streak as well, you know, we have to find a way to play as close to 48 minutes like that as possible.
Michael, Aaron Gordon, you've mentioned that you sort of want him to be as aggressive as possible and sort of get back to trying to get to the line, inviting contact, that sort of stuff. His scoring has been down early in this season. Do you think that there's some of that is like the free throw percentage that's been down for him, sort of impacting, you know, the willingness to invite that kind of contact and get into that type of game that he can be really good at playing?
Yeah, I'm not sure. Obviously, he's not shooting it well from the foul line right now, or from the three. And I think those numbers, both those areas, will go up for him. You know, he's in the gym. He's working on his game. He's working on his free throws and his three-point shooting. I do think there are times when he is being aggressive, when he is putting pressure on the rim and the defense. And sometimes he may not be getting the call, or sometimes maybe he's bailing out the defender at the last minute and maybe fading away as opposed to going through your chest and putting more pressure on the officials to make that call. But you've heard me say a lot in Denver that I think an aggressive Aaron Gordon is a very effective Aaron Gordon. And whether it's rim running, whether it's rebounding, pushing the ball, playing behind the defense, where him and Nicole have great, great synergy. You know, obviously we need Aaron to play at a high level for us. He's such an important piece to what we're trying to do, and I fully expect him to do that.
What does stand out about the Hawks to you so far this season?
Yeah, well, you have a dynamic backcourt. Obviously, Trae Young is scoring, playmaking. The guy is just a joy to watch offensively. DeJounte Murray, you know, in this building last year dominated us. There were times where we felt we were playing good defense, and he is a great mid-range shooter, just raced up and shot over our defenders. You know, but they scared me in transition. They're a top five running team. They get a lot of that over defense. I think they're around third in steals per game. They live at the foul line. Trae Young gets there 9 times a game, which I think is top five. And they're rebounding. I mean, Clint Capella, Okongwu, those guys, even Sadiq Bey. Clint Capella is second at 4.8 offensive rebounds per game on the season, which is an incredible number. In the last 5 games, he's at around 6.4, which is unheard of. And that's not just, you know, talking about their plays, just their ability to score in transition, their ability to get to the free throw line, and their ability to dominate the glass are all concerning.
Michael, now that it's over, how do you think the end season tournament turned out?
I think it was great. I didn't watch 1 minute of it, but you know, I was watching Bass Reeves.
The Colors had a couple tough shooting nights. Going back and watching the film, is there anything that you can help it with, or just those moments happen in a season and or in a career?
Yeah, you know what's funny about it? You know, Nicole and I were talking after last game, and I just making sure that he is not, you know, losing any confidence, which knowing him, I know he won't, but I want to make sure he's not, and just continue to remind him how much that, you know, we all continue to believe in him. Whether he goes 9 for 32 or 15 for 15, I think he's getting great looks. He's getting shots that he normally makes. And that's the key, Scott. As long as he's getting the looks that we're trying to generate. And the number of shots in the last 2 games where he's caught the ball in the pocket off of the pick and roll or in the post or in the paint, but he hasn't finished. I don't remember any other time in his 9-year career, and maybe I'm missing something, where he's had back-to-back games where he's missed that many of those shots. But as I mentioned, we're getting great looks, and you know, the guy, in my opinion, is the best player in the world, and I have all the confidence, even if he misses every shot tonight. nine years and a couple of MVPs and a world championship trophy is not going to had me lose any bit of confidence in Nikola Jokic.
Thank you, Coach.
All right, appreciate it, everybody.